people are dominated by their distorted, naughty, crazy mind. And that's why we say, mind your own business. We never say, body your own business. We never say. Because misery is less because of the body, more because of the mind. That's it. Like in a computer system, if the hardware is well and good, but software is corrupt, will it function properly? No. So mind is the software. We have to correct the software. In case, say for example, the hard disk is having virus, what do we do then? Can we use the hard disk? Say pen drive is there. Now pen drive is giving me pain. I want to dry away the pain of the pen drive. But it's not functioning. Why? Because there is virus. So what do we do? McAfee, Norton, Quick Heal, AVG, right? Before using the hard disk, we clean the hard disk. And then we are able to use the pen drive. Similarly, mind is also like a pen drive. In case there are viruses on the mind, we can't use the mind. Although the mind is very powerful. We can use the mind for our own benefit. But in case there are viruses in the mind, we have to run the antivirus. Now on the mind, Norton works?
No.
McAfee works?
No.
AVG works?
No.
Quick Heal works?
No.
What to do? So that way, here comes the role of spirituality. Spirituality sanctifies the mind. It purifies the mind. And when the mind is purified, then the mind can be used for a higher purpose. Otherwise, Lord Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, if mind is uncontrolled, it is the worst of enemy. When it is controlled, it is the best of friend. So our worst of enemy is not outside. Our worst of enemy is lying within the mind. So that case, immediate cause is the crazy nature of mind. And we become very obedient slaves of our minds. That is the immediate cause of misery.